very well welcome to Cup of Sports 3.0. I'm your co-host for this evening, Alan Moore. We are doing a very, very quick, short, sharp, and very select preview of the Euros semi-final today. Of course, that is between France and Spain. And I'm delighted to welcome in straight away our man out in Siberia, Mr. Andrew Flint. Andrew, before we start off, we were sent in a couple of clips, of course, by one of our producers of one of the most recent games, actually, played by France and Spain. One thing I was told was there will be lots and lots of cards and lots of diving, lots of shenanigans, and probably a lot more going on besides football. So we'll have a very, very quick clip before we start it off and before we dive into things.
The luck against Benfica. Into the path, Cristiano Ronaldo, who's one touch. He's going to take it to the left-hand side. Plays Garnacho here.
Okay, I think that was the wrong video we were sent in, but it doesn't make a difference. Andrew, this game this evening is going to be a tough one. We've got France with not a great record against Spain. They've only won 13 of their matches that they've played. They have lost 19, 7 draws. They won the last match. They lost one before. They won the one before that in a friendly. But this means more. On paper, Spain have it. But football isn't played on paper.
Well, logic would tell you Spain win this one. They've been easily the most impressive team, certainly still left in the tournament, and even of the size not. They showed real character to beat Germany in the quarterfinals. Against the hosts were, in my opinion, absolutely filthy, fouling, tactical fouling all day long. Very good side, but my God, they were dirty and they were aggressive. But Spain stood up to it, which is not something you traditionally associate with Spanish sides, but they showed that character. Their two young wingers, Nico Williams and Lamine Yamal, are almost unplayable when they're on form. So Spain know they've always got that option if things get tough in the middle. But in the middle, they have arguably the best, or one of the best controlling midfielders in Rodri. And they have plenty of depth in their squad as well. When Pedri went off injured, on comes Dani Olmo, and he slots straight in, sets up the winner for Spain. So France are a bit chaotic. They always are. They've been very ineffective. They've been branded as dull in this tournament because they've struggled to score. No goals from open play still. Kylian Mbappe is still not firing. There's been talk of tactical details being leaked from their camp this week. And France, the stereotype of France is that they are a chaotic bag of nightmares in tournaments, which, like you say, though, it's not played on paper. Switch that into football logic, that means France should probably win this one. But no, I'm sticking with Spain in this one. I do think they are just simply too good. And they've been challenged, and they've passed that challenge with Germany in the last round. France, I just don't think, have the character or the quality to match Spain. Not that they aren't good themselves, but I just don't think they have enough.
Is this Spain side something similar to what we saw in 2010, 2012, 2008, that kind of like era of a team? Because the intensity of their play, the running alone, which always for me raises red flags, but the running alone really does match up to that team from the late noughties, early 10s. What is different about them from that team? Like, is it that they've got better players, better coaching, or just better tactics? Because they're not playing tiki-taka as much, Andrew. They are playing, selective balls as well.
Well, this is the thing. That side from that won three consecutive tournaments, they just squeezed the life out of you. They were just a python wrapping themselves around teams and just squeezing joy out of the game almost. But this side, what I'd say is different is the different ways in which they attack, particularly, like I mentioned earlier, the two young wingers. They've completed the most dribbles as a pair of any country in the tournament so far. I think it's something like 60 dribbles they've attempted between them in what is 5 games so far. And they are trusted. So, you know, they have their wingers for sheer pace. They can take players on one-for-one better than almost anybody in the tournament. But they still have those metronomic passes in midfield. They have clever players linking up the play. I mentioned Pedri and Dani Olmo. Both of them can play that role. And so it almost, in a sense, doesn't matter that Alvaro Morata is the striker up front, who personally I think is absolutely useless. But they have more options, more ways to break sides down. Before, it was just squeeze the light out of sides and wait until they just passed out from just lack of ability to breathe. And it was almost like Homer Simpson boxing style. That's what Spain were. They were so effective at absorbing every punch and then just one little push. And that's it, a knockout win. Decide they can do everything almost.
In saying that, of course, you're being very down on Spain. France, of course, have some terrific players. Of course, one, we know straight away, Dembélé is extremely good. Well, world-class. Mbappé, of course, people are knocking down saying he's not as good as we thought he was. But I think that's people who were playing Football Manager or basically listening to, you know, selective games in the Champions League, are saying, oh, he's not a good of a player now because he's played in the French League. Well, he was very good a couple of years ago playing in the French League, but, you know, there we go. They also have Antoine Griezmann, who hasn't really fired as well as many would have hoped in this championship. If France are to win, I think they're going to do it. I think that they're going to beat Spain. But if they're going to do it, what do they need to do?
Well, they need to not panic, which is the easiest thing to say and the hardest thing to do. But by not panic, I simply mean there just simply is no rush. They have unbelievable passes. And like you mentioned, Griezmann is one of the most intelligent link-up players in world football at the moment. They need him to run the show because he can choose the right pace. They have rapid wings. They have really, really quick attacking options. But they don't need to thread balls through them every single time. They can just slow it down, keep the ball away from Spain, because we know Spain, even though they're not the tiki-taka of 10, 15 years ago, they still love to dominate possession. Well, don't let them have that. Keep the ball. There is no rush. And I think they also have to hope that Mbappé does not get too worried with having to solve every problem by himself. I think that's one issue. I don't want to say an issue with him, but perhaps an issue with the system and the team. He feels like there's such a weight on his shoulders that he's the one who has to solve the problems. He has to beat three or four men instead of just beat one or find a better player or play in a better position. So if he can keep his head, Griezmann gets on the ball and they don't panic and rush, they have every chance of frustrating Spain. But again, like I say, that's the easiest thing to say, the hardest thing to do.
Of course, it'd be great in one way to see Didier Deschamps win a double-double because, he won the Euros and World Cup as a player, and he could do it as well as a manager. So again, it'd be, from what I've heard from people within French media, within French football, that this would be it. He's actually going to completely retire from football altogether. I don't think that's true, but he's going to step down because basically there's nothing more he can do. I think it's more that he has an extremely lucrative role offered to him by two clubs right now in the world. But again, I think the rumours around this aren't to be believed just yet. Okay, Andrew, hand on heart, what is the result tonight?
I don't think it's going to be. I don't think it's going to be clear cut, but I'm going to go. I'm going to go for a Spain win in this one, just because they have been so impressive. It could go any. It could go either way. Admittedly, it could be very close. I don't think they're going to run away with it. It's not going to be a 3 or 4 nil. Now that I've said that, it probably will be. But no, I think Spain will edge it. A goal, two goals in it, nothing more than that.
Okay, well, we'll see if you keep your run going. You've redeemed yourself for the weekend, so let's fingers crossed. Andrew, thank you very much. Talk to you tomorrow.
Catch you, boss.
Okay, and we will go out right now with, I think a song is going to get us kind of like grooving for the game. It's kickoff in just over an hour. So until then, take care of yourselves, take care of each other. And of course, we will speak with you tomorrow night with our prediction for the England-Holland game. Back tomorrow. Poker, get your 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 poker.